Hey there.
Very well today, Mr. Edelman.
I've been practicing.
I can tell.
May I ask you a personal question?
Depends on the question.
Well, it's not really a personal question. Actually, it's more of an embarrassing question, weird question.
What?
You've been coming here a while, and... It's just too strange.
But, oh, Mr. Edelman.
I'm going to lie down with you, with your body pressed against mine. I want to hold you like a woman.
Is this okay?
The greatest day of my life.
When we examine what we experience, we are describing the things of this world. But of course, a Nietzschean twist, when we describe the things of this world from the first person, we are quite clearly describing always from a perspective.
Thank you so much. Hello? Hi.
Hi.
I saw you sitting there. I've been passing you for the past few weeks. You're always here, and I thought, today I'm gonna do something for you. So I brought you something to eat.
Thanks.
Of course, I mean, it's exactly what I had for lunch.
Can you bring it to me?
Of course. Of course.
It's real nice. These are my favorite foods from McDonald's.
Mine too.
This is what you had?
Exactly.
That's uncanny. Can I?
Of course. Is there anything else I can get you? Can I get you anything else?
Tampons. I need tampons bad. When I feel my period coming on, I'm totally out.
Okay, sure.
Get me Super Plus and regulars, because I get a very heavy period.
Mine too, I know how it is.
Thanks. Donna.
Cynthia.
Are you a vegetarian or anything like that?
No. Whatever you're eating, I'll eat.
Oh,
I'm making them like Mom made them. Yeah.
Oh, remember that woman I told you about? The one I would see at the bus stop? Exactly, that one. I stopped today and talked to her. She was perfectly normal and didn't seem like a druggie or freak or anything like that. Just, you know, so grateful and normal. Who knows? Oh, when I handed her the lunch I brought her, she said it was uncanny how I picked her favorite foods. Uncanny. The exact word she used. So interesting. She lives at a bus stop now. I don't know. I don't know how that happens. You know, life, one false move, one domino falls, and you know, who knows? No, I don't care. I need them. They're not addictive, and they make me feel great in the morning. And I need to feel great in the morning, otherwise my day is shot. Dear Lichtenstein 282, I hope you like my sexy pics. I shot them for you. P.S. I think you have a beautiful cock. I got you dinner.
Oh, are you sleeping?
Donna?
Thanks for the pics. You look very nice, but no disrespect, you're not really my type. Which doesn't mean to say that I won't fuck you. I will, but only for money. If you want a cock like mine, you're gonna have to pay for it. Thanks again for the compliment. Roy, my real name. What's yours?
It is who I am, in a way, that is determined by the world, that is determined by my activities in the world. It is an accumulation of all of my achievements and failures in such a way that the way I describe myself as a self is no different from the way someone else would describe me.
Probably wondering what happened to me, right? Why I'm like this?
Like what?
I had a mother. My father. I don't know. He said he was 50 and then he turned out to be 60. Maybe more. He was an artist. He said he lived in France and Italy and Germany and he taught art all over. And he said he was 50 and then he turned out to be 60. So what am I supposed to believe? When he died, they said he was 80. And I thought he was 70. He was 70, then they said he was 83. I never knew that. I knew something else and then it turned out not to be true. He was lying.
10 years, then 13 years, and I don't know what to believe. Do you know? Do you know what to believe?
No, not really. I believe people are basically good. I mean, that even in the worst situations, you can find the good.
I don't know. How does anyone know anything? Why would he say that? Why did he lie?
And your mother?
She's somewhere. I had a scooter. I needed to buy something, so I got on the scooter and I was going to buy it. I had a job, I had money and a boyfriend, I was in college, I was going to buy some coke. Did you ever do coke?
When I was in college, just once or twice.
Drugs. You a drug addict? Do you use a dildo?
No.
I bet you are. I bet you have a great big plastic dick that you fuck yourself with. I bet in your bedroom, in the top drawer of your night table. Don't lie to me.
It's none of your business, even if I did, and I don't.
I was going to buy some coke, and I was on my scooter. There was this guy, not my boyfriend. I was gonna bring him the coke. Met him at work. He was... Do you know what a skinhead is?
Oh, I think so. What did you do? Finish your story.
You gonna come back tonight?
Are you looking at my breasts?
No.
You were. Don't lie to me. Do you like my breasts?
Well, sure.
Do you want to touch them? And hold them? I can make that a part of your therapy. For a fee.
Are you kidding?
Touch them. Tell me how much you like my breasts.
They're like little secrets. Thank you for sharing with me. Oh.
Computer. Maybe I can figure it out with a computer. I have an email address.
I can't bring you a computer. I can let you use mine, though.
I want my own.
They're expensive.
No, they're not.
Hi, Donna. I didn't finish my story.
Oh, what story?
story you didn't let me finish.
Oh, sorry.
You brought me something?
I brought you the new computer you wanted, and some dinner, and some water.
Water?
Staff of life.
It's bread. Bread is the staff of life. Water is water. Water is boring. I told you I wanted fries and a shake. I was hoping for fries and a shake from you.
I can bring that to you tomorrow, but this is what I made for myself, for my own dinner tonight. And I'm sharing it with you. And I brought you a brand new computer. You should check it out. I mean, there's Wi-Fi around here. You can go online.
The period came on very, very strong.
Oh, it's good I got you those tampons. Just in time, huh?
And my luggage is falling apart.
I see.
I can fix it with wire. I was thinking about it tonight, and I think I can fix it with wire. You don't have to buy me any new luggage. I can fix it myself.
Okay. I'll see what I can do.
There's nothing to see. You can get it at the hardware store. It's not very complicated.
You're probably right.
I was on my scooter. My father was nearby. Mm-hmm. We were in San Francisco in those days. We lived there. I can tell you that. That part is okay for me to tell you.
It's a pretty place.
I had a job at a picture framer. A relative owned it, a cousin, except he was an asshole, and I always had to beg to be paid, and I hated that.
Oh yeah, that's not right.
Did you ever have to beg to be paid?
Well, not exactly beg, but I have had some pretty rotten bosses in my time. Made it seem they were doing me a favor when they were only doing what was right.
Assholes. I hate assholes. I hate having to beg.
Me too.
I had to beg for what was rightfully mine. Do you know how that is?
No.
You've begged. You've probably begged for cock.
I'm not going to beg, but I am going to pay to fuck this guy. He said to me, he wrote to me.
You gonna pay this guy? You're a real idiot.
Okay. I thought you'd be impressed that I'm not going to beg. I'd rather pay than beg.
Very fucking impressive. Stupid bitch.
What are you doing to me?
I'm gonna put my hand in you.
No, no, Donna, it'll hurt too much.
I need work gloves.
What?
It
to work the wire. Otherwise, it'll cut my hands. I'll bleed if you don't get the gloves.
Okay, come. Oh, Donna. Donna. Donna, what are you?
Oh, Donna!
Being so nice, forget what I said. I'll throw you a freebie. When and where can we meet? Roy.
Tonight. My place. 580 Wood Creek Way, Unit G, Playa Del Rey. Cynthia.
The important point here is that consciousness itself in no sense contains the I, in no sense contains the self. And our experience has to be understood in terms of, as Heidegger put it, tasks to be completed, people in the world to be appealed to, a sense of things to be done. What counts as the self, on the other hand, is going to be the sort of thing that we find in the biography.
See the wire.
I forgot the gloves. Sorry.
I thought he was 50, but then he was 60, except he was 63.
Which one was it?
Which one was it?
Oh, I don't know. I'm sorry. You know, people lie about their age sometimes. It's just for vanity or something. Like that? It's not a terribly big deal.
My hands are going to bleed now. Why didn't you get the gloves? My hands are gonna hurt.
I forgot. I just forgot.
You wanna make me beg?
It has nothing to do with that. No, it was just an
You're trying to make me beg, and I won't. And now my hands are going to hurt. It's your fault.
Where's the luggage?
It's over there.
Thank you.
with their bodies. People are subject to the material cause and effect relationship in the world, which is a way of saying, self-jointly, that we are both being in itself. This is a sense in which we are not simply bodies.
Oh my God.
Thank you.